Today I'm going to be redesigning this book cover. We're going to make it less cluttered, a lot more appealing to the eyes. We'll make three options together, and then I want you to tell me which one you think is best with just a couple of simple design tricks really quickly. And we'll be using Adobe XD, completely free program you can get started on your own today if you want. So let's design something. Welcome back to another video, and today we need to clean up this cover design. This is just one book in a massive series of commentaries. Now, the content inside these books are amazing. Al Mohler, David Platt, Tony Morita, Danny Akin are all fantastic authors of the faith, but not everyone is a designer, and so they may not have even had that much control or say in what the final cover looked like. But one thing important to us is that we are presenting Christ-like work with good design, right? If we care about the word, we need to be focusing on how we're packaging and presenting that content to other people. But enough talking about it, let's design something already. So we're gonna jump in. Okay, so I'm in Adobe XD now, and the first thing that we're gonna do is take the rectangle tool and line it around some of the text just to get some hierarchy going. And this is a tactic that I learned from Will Patterson, an amazing Christian calligrapher, graphic designer. You can check him out on YouTube. But this is a great way to figure out the hierarchy of your design. So now I have all of my boxes around all the text and the elements and things, and I went ahead and add a box down here around the picture because remember, all of the commentaries have that little picture at the bottom of it, and so they all kind of went with that design, but in my opinion, it's a little bit of an afterthought. I mean, obviously the cross is important. I mean, let's be real. Ooh, it's thundering outside. The cross is important. Eek. But if I take this picture and I slide it out of the way to reveal just the boxes, it is kind of a mess. Like, it's, and all I would know is to think that this text is really important and this text is really important and these are just little filler boxes. But it's actually not true, because that little box right there is for Hebrews, and then this one is for words that, you know, I don't know, like Jesus, that I think are pretty important. Now again, no offense, because clearly I am a Danny Akin fan. I went to his school, studied under him. All of these people, all these authors are great, but I'm gonna make them names smaller, and I'm gonna make names like Hebrews and Jesus, exalting Jesus in, a lot bigger. Okay, so once that's done, you want to start with a clean white artboard here. To do that, all you have to do is go over to this little artboard tool, and then you can start drawing it around. And then once you have the artboard there, you want to make it 1800 pixels wide by 2700 pixels height-wise. Obviously, that's not the end-all, be-all, and I'm not going to focus too much on template design and lines and stuff like that. Normally, you're going to design both covers together, the front and the back. We're not even talking about the back today. We're just talking about the front. So something that I did like about the original book here is this little badge right here, this little New Testament commentary badge, NT or New Testament there. And so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that and I am going to make my own little badge here. I'm going to make it black. But what we're going to do now is get a little bit more designy with it and turn it sideways. And I think I would like it here just on the side, and for two reasons. So the first reason is it's kind of cool, and it catches your eye, and you're like, why is that sideways? And in doing that, I've already captured your attention because you've asked, why is it sideways? Number two, it helps you find the book quickly. So in a stack of books, if all of them are clean and the one has a little tab here on the side, you can quickly find it in a stack of books. Okay, so we're going to take the name of the commentary, and we're going to make it bold, and we're going to make it a lot bigger because it is the, you know, it's the name of the book. That's pretty good. I think it's a little big. Let's bring it down just a tad. Space that out. And it's already looking pretty good. I mean, that's a pretty nice size title for this current moment. We can play with it as we move on. So now we need to place Christ-centered exposition somewhere. And we're going to take this lighter font here. We're going to make that black again. And we're going to put in Christ-centered exposition, and we're also going to make that bold. You can explore with the different weights of this font, but for right now I think that bold and light are the two ones that you would want to do. So either light or regular, and bold or something like heavy, depending on which version you have, or if you're using regular Helvetica or Helvetica New like this one. And so now already, if we look at these side by side, it's getting pretty clear that this one is a lot cleaner, it's a lot easier to read. And now that we kind of have all of our different elements here, we're just going to delete that. We don't really need it anymore. So now we're going to make a separate artboard. All you have to do is click on this actual artboard, hold the Alt or the Option key, click it, and then drag it over. You want to hold the Shift key to make sure that it doesn't float and do all this stuff like that. And so now we can title this Book Cover 2. So I've already actually chosen an image that I like, but if we go back here and we want to go to unsplash.com, that is a place full of high resolution artwork, and they do a great job. I've used them for book covers in the past, and just make sure that if you use them, you credit the author of the photo in your book. Just a little pro tip there. So now that we've downloaded that, I'm gonna pull in this image into XD. It's gonna keep it the same resolution, which is really nice. We're gonna format this right over the artboard, and then we're going to send it to the back. Some of this text kind of gets washed out, but we're gonna make this a little bit bigger, this tan part a little bit bigger, so it's easier to read that Christ-centered exposition part. Make sure the cross is aligned there in the middle. And we're gonna take this text and make it white. And that text already looks pretty good. And then what I think I might do is move this over a little bit, because I really like how it's kind of blending in to this tan. So we're going to make it out like this and bring this up just a tad like that. And I think we're getting pretty solid here. It's very eye-catching, but let's keep going and do a couple of different design tricks, because I think we can make this a little bit better. So the first thing we want to do is take this image and we're going to make it smaller, because I really like how it looks like the cross is in a funnel. Then we'll go up here and we'll click on the artboard and we're going to change the fill to black. Now, it already's got some sauce here. It looks pretty cool, but we need to make sure all of this stuff turns to white. Ooh, it's gonna look, ooh, that looks really fierce. And so you can tell here, I'm gonna expand this a little bit, bring this one in. Actually, I'm gonna bring this up and give it like that little dot effect here, like this. And yeah, that's looking pretty clean. So now we have two options here, but I was inspired by a different style that I wanna try. So let's do this. Let's bring the book cover over again. We'll label this one Book Cover 4. We'll actually delete this. We'll change everything back to white. So change the artboard back to white. Highlight everything with your mouse and change it to black. So now everything's black again. And we want to go over here and click the rectangle or the square tool. And I want you to make a rectangle right here. And so already we're running into a couple of spatial errors here on my part that we're going to clean up a little bit. But we want to click the align tool. So make sure that's aligned here. We'll take this text, align it here, take this text, bring it over right here, and move this up forward. And then we're gonna take this text, move it up just a little bit, and move this back down. And so now what's cool about this box is that if we bring in the image and hover it over the box, you see how it turns blue like that. And if I let go, it's gonna replace that box with this image. And so now we have a kind of a different, like, a different style vibe here, and we can lift it up or down and make it however we want it. And now we have like kind of a very old school type looking book cover. And you can see in just a couple of minutes, now we have three pretty solid options for a book cover that use simple design, making sure that the headline is the most important thing. Again, no offense to the authors of this book, they are phenomenal, and no offense to the book cover designer, but it's just not very good, so, you know, yeah. And so here are the four options that I have mocked up for you to check out. You let me know in the comments, do you like option A, option B, C, or D? Keep it simple. That is the main golden rule for any kind of design. Start in black and white, start with simple, then add your images, add your graphics, your vectors, whatever you gotta do. But first, you want to keep it simple. So I hope this has been helpful for you. If anything, entertaining at least. Don't forget to like and share this video, especially my Southeastern peeps. Let me know what you think. Share it around. Let me know if you'd want to see books with that kind of cover on top of them. I've done some in the past, but doing an entire series like this would be so cool. And so it'd be interesting to hear what you think. Make sure you like it. Share it around. And subscribe if you're into the design space or just want to see more videos of us breaking down things and doing tutorials and stuff like that. Hit the red button right there. It's going to help me out. It makes me incredibly happy. It makes my day. So if you want to hit that, it'd be awesome. So I hope you have a great one. And until next time, I'll see you in the next video.